Good morning, dear students. Today we'll start isometric projections. Now, see, the isometric projection is we are trying to see all the three views. All the three views in 2D. That is, on a piece of paper where we have got length and breadth, I am trying to show three dimensions. That is isometric projection. Now, here what we do, first we take up planes. Now, this rectangle plane, it is looking like ABCD is looking like a rectangle having opposite sides equal and all angles are 90 degrees. This is a rectangle in plane geometry. Now in isometric projection, same thing when it is taken to isometric projection, here, front view it is, what we have is, we have one 90 degrees as usual, here like this. This AB line has left side 90, here also 90. Right side is 90 as converted into 60 degrees now. This angle B is converted to 60. And this length BC also gets shortened by 81%. This isometric length BC becomes 81% of true length. Now, let's see, I draw again perpendicular. Now this left angle, if you see, it is 90. Now it has become 120. And here angle D becomes 60. Angle A becomes 90. What we observe is AD is equal to BC, AB equal to CD, but they are less in dimensions. The dimensions are 81% of true lengths. But when you come to angle, B and D have become 60 degrees and A and C have become 120. Therefore, in isometric, we are not going to draw angles. Now, this is your front view. This is your top view. How do you draw? Draw a vertical line, draw a perpendicular, mark AB, at B draw 60 degrees, measure BC, cut off, draw a perpendicular, draw a parallel line. Here, when it is planned, top view, at B draw 30 degrees on either side. 30, 30. Measure this, convert it into isometric length, cut off A and C, at A draw parallel to BC, at C draw parallel to AB. Triangle, first we draw a rectangle. Isometric rectangle you draw, take midpoint of BA here, take midpoint, join 3, 2, 3, 1. Same thing here. When it comes to pentagon, draw pentagon first. Now, surmount it with a rectangle. Surmount pentagon with a rectangle. So, now, what we do? First we draw ABCD pentagon. Extend BC on either side, at A and D draw perpendiculars, cutting at 2 and 3, at E draw a line parallel to 2, 3. You get 1, 2, 3 for a rectangle. And all corners are on this rectangle. So first we draw isometric rectangle. Isometric rectangle first I draw. Then on this, you take these measurements and put B, C, D, E, etc. All these things have to be measured from here, mark here. Then join them. This is isometric projection of a orthogonal projection. These are all true shapes. We call them as orthogonal projections. These are isometric. In isometric, we have got two. One is front view, other is top view. That is, if we have this as top view and this, if this as front view, sorry, you are seeing, all of you are seeing this as front view. Now if it is top view like this, it is top view. You have to see from top. You can't see from front. This you can see from front. Top view you see from there. Yes? One student want once again. Yes, now dear students, this is a rectangle ABCD. What I have is this rectangle. I want to see in isometric view. Isometric view in the same paper, whatever you are having in your notebook, on that paper, I can show only length and breadth. Now I am supposed to show height also towards you. This is length and breadth you are seeing. Front view, length and breadth you are seeing. This thickness is not seen. I want to show you thickness also. Thickness should come like this. So what I am doing, I am turning it this way. I am turning it this way. So and I turn it this way. First, it is a front view. All of you know this front view, everyone knows, right? Now I am rotating it slightly. Now you are seeing two views. Front view is this, side view is this. Side view, front view. Top you are not able to see. Now I turn it this way. Vertical plane is like this. It is not changing. When I turn it this way, all the three views you are seeing. You are able to see top view. You are able to see front view. You are able to see left side view. All the three views you are seeing. So to draw this, what we are doing is, first draw a vertical line. At here draw 30 degrees. Measure this distance BA, BC. BA, BC, you cut off. At A, draw a parallel. At C, draw a parallel. They intersect at D. This is front view. Top view, 30, 30 on either side. This is 30, this is 30. Then measure AB, BC. BA, BC, cut off. At A, draw a parallel line. At C, draw a parallel. This is front view of a rectangle. This is top view of a rectangle. For a triangle, we do same thing. Take these midpoints. Take these midpoints, join to 1, 2. You get a triangle. Triangle straight you cannot draw because I told you this angle you cannot draw. Here, once I am showing 90 degrees as 60. Angle B is 90, it is shown as 60. Angle A is 90, here I am showing 120. Isometric view, you should not draw angles. Now I have drawn a pentagon. I surmount pentagon with a rectangle. We know how to draw a rectangle. We have drawn rectangle. Now measure these distances. 2A, 2B, 3C, etc. Mark on this, then join them. Yes. Why only 60 degrees is? I have to again start afresh. See, in my previous class I gave it isometric. This I cannot tell because now I have to show you isometric, conversion of orthographic and isometric. We will see. So for some of those people who are not understood, if there is any possibility of getting one more class, I will try. But today is the only last class I have got. I have to complete three topics. Isometric, what I am doing now, conversions both. So let's go. We can't stop. Yes. Now, this I will explain later on. Yes. Now, hexagon, how to draw? Yes. Whenever they are asking you to draw isometric projectometric length, whenever they are asking you to draw isometric view, you can take normal scale. I think all of you should know isometric scale and normal scale. Normal scale, anyway, you know. Isometric scale, I think if you want, I will send a note. I can't tell now. Isometric scale, I will again send you a note. That scale you have to use. Yes. Now, this hexagon also, draw a hexagon, surmount with the rectangle. Now, measure these distances, mark here. These two are midpoints, mark like that. Then join them. Circle, I will explain you later on. Now, this pentagon already we have seen. How to draw isometric pentagon we have seen. We have drawn this. This is the isometric pentagon we have drawn. We have already drawn. We know how to draw. So, I have drawn this isometric pentagon. Then, find out the centroid. How do you do that? From one, join the midpoint of this. From here, join this midpoint. At least you should have two. It is better to confirm third one also. It is always better to draw third one also, but it is always preferable to have three. Okay, I have drawn, there he has drawn only two, this is the central. From here you project height, you project the height, then this apex is joined with all the points, then this becomes a pyramid. What about prism? From A, B, C, D, E, draw vertical lines of given heights, say 75. From A, B, C, D, E, draw vertical lines, then all the top corners you join. Anyway, these things again we will see. Now this is prism, hexagonal prism. First we have drawn the hexagon, on that you draw all 75 degrees, 75 height. Height is given 75, you join all the vertical lines, all these vertical lines you join, then you get it. This is front view. I told you this is 90 degrees, this is 30. You draw this pentagon. Now from here you draw 30 degrees left side. To this I'll draw all parallel lines, 75 mm draw parallel lines. Here I have drawn all vertical lines, here I am drawing 30 degrees line parallel to this 30 degrees. So we get all these lines, then join them. This is hexagonal prism. Circle again I'll tell you. Next is slide number 23. Yes. Now this is a cube. First we draw the rectangle bottom, rectangle or square, whatever it is, you draw bottom. And there you draw the height 50 on all the four corners. Draw height 50, then you get the top face. Now this is maybe 50, the side is 50, it is 30 now. So what I do, from here, everywhere I mark 10 mm, 10 mm, 10 mm, 10 mm, then join them. Then I get another parallelogram. For this 30 mm pyramid, what I do is, here I mark 10 mm, here I mark 10 mm, 10 mm, 10 mm everywhere. This 10 mm, this 10 mm I join, then I get this line. If I join this 10 mm, this 10 mm, it's also you get. So you get this pentagon, the parallelogram. Sorry, it will be a rhombus, not parallelogram. All sides are equal, this parallelogram becomes a rhombus. Now height, again height is the midpoint of this. You draw the height, 50 height is already given to you. So from there you join these things. Now next we go to slide number 54. Yes. Now dear students, this is the side view he has given in this figure. See, this, it has got two pieces, 10 mm, 10 mm. It's a L shape. Dear student, this is an L shape. This one is L shape. Right? On this, I have got one more piece here. This is not known to us. This figure you are supposed to draw. The question is only this much. Now, L shape is given to you like this. There is a dashed line. Dashed line, I told you, it is hidden. Therefore, this line is hidden line. This, there is a slot here. This material has been removed. So I get a dashed line. Why do I get dashed line? This much of material is removed. The height is 60. Thickness of this is, if you are seeing from here, this thickness is 60 and this is a square, 30 square. This is the piece. Now what do you do? First, we have to draw the bottom plate we will draw. This is bottom plate. How much is the height? Length he has given, length, breadth. You draw the parallelogram. Length and breadth, you draw the parallelogram. From there, you draw the height, 20 plus 50, 70. This is again 20. First, I'll show you. I start here, draw 30 degrees. Here you draw vertical line 70. Thickness is 20. Come back 20. Come down. Up to what? This is 10. This is 10. This must be 20. Then you draw a parallel line here. You draw a vertical line. They cut here. Here you draw 30 degrees. Here you draw 30. Here also you draw 30. So bottom plate is fixed. Now this height I have to draw. Here you draw 30 degrees on left side. The width, length of this is given here, 60. 60 you mark. From there again you draw. Take the center point here. On either side, this is 30, this is 60. So this must be 15, this must be 15. Here you mark 15, 15, draw vertical lines. Then you get these two lines. From here you mark 15, from there you mark 15. Top he has not given. This is 50, this is 30. How much is this? 50 minus 30, 20 divided by 2. So 10 mm you mark. On this you got this. Here, draw 30 degrees. This length is 40. Draw 30, 40 length. 30 degrees, 40 length. Dear students, in isometric we draw 60 degrees from bottom or from top 30 degrees. Both are same, no? Alternate angles. If this is 60, this will become 30 here. This becomes 30, this becomes 30. This is 120. This becomes 60. So this three, there are only three angles. 30, 60, 90. This is 30, this is 60, this is 90. Right? Again, we will see. Construction again, we will see. Then we go to 38. This figure you are supposed to draw, he has given you this. Now, the if you are seeing from left side view, this is L shape. And there are steps here. 1, 2, 3 steps. This is left side view. That is this view. This view is looking like this. Actually, if this figure is given, drawing this is easy. If this is given, drawing this is easy. But he has given you this, you are supposed to draw this. First, let me explain this. Reverse, again we'll see. Suppose he has given you this, how to draw. Now, this is your front view. This is left side view. This is top view. Now, I am drawing front view. Right? I start with O. O, draw a horizontal line. This length. Dear student, he has not shown you dimensions, but in the examination, he will give you dimensions. Mark this length up to this. Again, mark this height up to this. Then this line up to this. From here to here is this line. Now this line is this one up to this. Again down completely. This is your front view. Now I have to draw these steps. From here, suppose this is, he has given 20, 20 has taken. From here you mark 20. Left 20, right 20, top 20, right 20, top 20. So these are looking like steps here. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. I'm seeing from front view. Start with O. Draw 30 degrees. Draw 60. Draw 30. Again, you draw one thing. You can draw a complete box also, no problem. I'll show you one problem with box. From there, you draw this. Whatever you are seeing. Here, you draw this. Again, you are seeing this. So you draw this also. Again, let me come to top view. Top view is looking like a 7. This is looking like 7. And I have what? Two rectangles here. Two rectangles. Top view looking like 7. Two rectangles. 7, 2 rectangles. Left side view, I see from here, L, two rectangles. L, this is one rectangle, this is another rectangle. Dimensions anyway, in this he has not given. But now, in the question, he has given you this question, you are supposed to draw this. What will you do? Take 4, draw 30 on either side. Height is given 60. You make the box. First we will draw the box. Complete box. This line comes up to this. This line comes up to this. Now you come to front view. He already has given you the dimensions. As per this, you draw. In the front view, you draw this. Steps. Now, what is the length of the step? 30. At each point, right? Each point, draw 30 length. Only 30 length. This is, mind it, this is 30 degrees, this is 30 degrees. We have drawn a box. There you draw the steps. From 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 30 mm. Then join all the lines. You get the step. Side view, see, what we do is, if you are seeing from here, you see a L and these two rectangles as per this. Now let us forget this, we'll concentrate only on this. If I see from this side, I should see L and these two rectangles. If I see from top, I should see 7, these two rectangles. If I see from front view, I should see the steps and there this is a wall. This is a wall. These are the steps. This is the figure. Now, I start from here, draw 30 degrees on either side. Draw vertical lines. This figure again we will see. Again, we will try to see it. Yes. I'll try to do whatever is possible, please. Now again, we are going to first pentagon. How to draw isometric? We have a pentagon. See, draw ABCD hexagon you have drawn. Side is 40 mm. Draw a hexagon, then complete the rectangle PQRS. PQRS is the rectangle. Right? Now, the distance is, from here it is 34.64, this is 20. QC is 20, QB is 34.64. Now, what I have drawn? Draw a point here. This is R, no? This total is 20, 40, 20. This is 80. And this is, say 69.2, 70. R is 70, this is 80. Now, put here R, R is 70, this is 80. 20, 40, 20. This is 80, this vertical is 34.65. Dear students, because I have drawn on an AutoCAD, you are getting decimal points, don't worry. You take distances from compass, whatever you get, 34 or 33, don't worry much. Then you draw this parallelogram, PQRS you can draw. First you draw horizontal line, mark a point R, R is 70, RQ 80. Draw a vertical line, draw a parallel line. They cut at P. Now measure the distance, 20. Here 20, here 20, here 20, here 20. Draw vertical lines. Generally why we draw vertical lines is, we don't mark four points. Just we take only one radius. QC we take, cutoff QC, cutoff RD, at D and C draw vertical lines. Don't take again compass dimensions. Now this is a midpoint, QB you mark 34.63, draw a horizontal line parallel. Now you got ABCD. Now once you join them, you get the isometric projection. This is the center point, how to get the center point. This is isometric projection, base side, resting on base, on HP. This is resting on HP. Now he has shown you two views. One is left side view, other is right side view. This is showing left, right side, this is left side view. Both are same. What you have done? Here I have taken SR vertical, QR left side. Now QR I have taken right side here. QR taken right side. Here QR is taken left side. If I take QR right side, 30 degrees, if I take QR right side, I get this figure. Both are same, both are not wrong, both are correct. This is isometric projection of, I told you, whenever he is asking you isometric projection, please take isometric dimension scale, isometric dimensions. If he says isometric view, take normal scale. Isometric projection, you take isometric dimensions. Now, this is resting on corner piece. Earlier, what I have drawn is like this, resting on base. Now it is resting on corner. See, it is resting on this corner. Previously, it is resting on base here. It is resting on base. Now, it is resting on corner. What I have done, instead of drawing here, I have taken Q here. Q was base. Now I made R as base. Now this is resting on corner. Here, I have taken R base, Q was above, RQ, RS. Now, I have taken, once again, R, but RQ was here, I just changed it to this way. RQ was here, I made RQ this way. Again, peacefully again, go through all this. Already half an hour is over. So these slides again, once again you go through. Still you have any problem, note down the slide number and we'll see after some time. And don't get unnecessary panic. Supplementary exams are there till 11:11. We have enough time. Enough time for us to meet again if there is a need. Don't worry much. Now today listen peacefully. Again, you go through all the slides in your house. Wherever there is a problem, note down the, say, file name, isometric projections 1, 2, 3, like that, slide number. Then you can, we'll discuss either personally or with again another class. Whatever is best possible, we'll do. Don't get unnecessary panic. Now, this is resting on corner. We'll go to circle, I did not tell you, that's more important. So, this is isometric already, I have told you. Now, this is circle, I want to draw a isometric circle, right? Now, I draw a parallelogram ABCD. How do you draw? Mark a point B, 30 degrees here, 30 degrees here. Length is 80, 80. BA, BCR 80, 80. Now, at A, draw BC parallel. At C, draw BA parallel. They cut at D. B, draw BC, BA. At A, draw parallel to BC. At C, draw parallel to BA. They cut at D. Now, I get a rhombus. If it is not a square, I get a parallelogram. If it is a square, I get a rhombus. Now, I have marked all the midpoints. P, Q, R, S. A, B, C is a rhombus. P, Q, R, S are midpoints. Now, I join these midpoints with corners. BND. See, I join BP, BS, DQ, DR. DQ, DR, BP, BS. And if you join AC, all the three lines must intersect at one point, L and M. They must be concurrent place. All the three lines must be concurrent. This AC I have joined only for confirmation. If I join AC, they must concur. Now, LS center, radius equal to LP. First, I have drawn this first. BS center, radius BP. BS center, radius BP, draw an arc. DS center, same radius, draw another arc. Two arcs I have given here. Next, LS center, radius LP. LS center, radius LP. MS center, radius SM. I get a ellipse. The isometric projection of the circle is ellipse. This is how we draw isometric projection of a circle. Again, I repeat. Because if you want to draw cone or cylinder, it's a must. I'm repeating it. Yes, yes. Recorded version, again, I'll share it to you. PPTs are already available with you. Any other thing you need it, we'll do it. Don't worry. Yes. Now, draw a horizontal line, mark point B. At B, draw 30 degrees on either side. Take compass AT. B as center, cut off C. B as center, cut off A. At A, draw a line parallel to BC. Draw a line parallel. At C, draw a line parallel to AB. They both cut at D. I got a rhombus. Now, I mark PQR as midpoints. I join opposite points R and Q with D. P and S opposite to B. Join them. If I join AC, all the points must be concurrent. Now, BS center, radius BP, draw an arc. DS center, same radius, draw another arc. BS center, radius, draw an arc. DS center, same radius, draw an arc. LS center, LP radius, draw an arc. MS center, same radius, draw another arc. These are present arcs, these are previous arcs. Both will join, you get the ellipse. Yes. Now, I'm going to draw their students. Just see here. What is this? This is the base. This is the top. For this solid, there must be a base. There must be similar, identical top also. Top and bottom must be identical. When I want to draw a solid, I've already drawn the base. This base I have drawn, no? If I want to draw a cylinder, I have to draw the top also. So one more ellipse I have to draw on top. That we will see here. See, first this is drawn. P, Q, R, S. At a height of 120, again draw P1, Q1, R1, S1. This we have already drawn, A, B, C, D. A, B, C, D we have drawn. A, B, C, D, rhombus, we have drawn all this. Right. Now what I do, here A, B, C, D is here. At a height of 120, again I repeat A1, B1, C1, D1. Either above or below, whatever you like. If this becomes top, you draw the lines downwards. If this becomes bottom, you draw lines upwards, whatever you like. So, whatever you have drawn here, above 120, please draw them. Then, again, repeat same thing. Once you got A1, B1, C1, D1, repeat all. You get one more ellipse here, one more ellipse here. Now, you join these two points, blue line, and this must be dashed in the line. This must be dashed. Dear students, this is the solid you are seeing, right? Now, when I turn it this way, this portion you cannot see. Backside is not visible. Whatever is not visible, you have to show dashing. When I turn it this way, you are seeing completely. Completely you are seeing, but this bottom portion you cannot see. This portion, see, BC is there, no? BC is here. It is BC is here like this. When I turn it, you cannot see BC. Top portion, all the four you are seeing. 1, 2, 3, 4 you can see, but BC is cannot be seen. So that's how backside portion you draw dashed lines. This is complete dark. One important thing what you should understand is outside lines are all dark. First darken this. I show you. See here, this line, this line, this line, they are all dark. Now inside lines there are two. This one, this one. Top lines all the four you are seeing, no? Bottom line only you are not able to see. Top all the four you are seeing. So you dash it. This is dark. Now what about pyramid? It is cylinder is okay. What about cone? Now you got O2. Don't draw all this. From O1, draw vertical line 120. From O2, draw a line O1, 120 height. This O1 and this. Dear students, don't join this. Don't join O1 with this. Draw a tangent from here. Don't ask me how. What you do is, take a scale. I don't have scale now. Take a scale. See that it does not touch. It touches circle, the ellipse at only one point. Slowly move the scale. The scale is like this. Slowly move it. It is here like this. Slowly move it. Wherever it just touches, there you draw a line. So, cylinder, cone are over. Now, prism. Dear students, this already we have seen PQRS, how to draw the hexagon we have seen. Now, complete this box. The height is 150. At RSPQ, PQRS, draw 150 lines. 1, 2, 3, there is one more line here. S and Q also are at same place. So, draw all 150 lines. Again, join them. You get one more rectangle. PQRS is here. At 30 degrees again. This also is 30 degrees. Draw this. Now, you can repeat same thing here. Or another method is from every line. Now, this is PQRS. A, B, C, D, E. These are the points on the hexagon. At every point, draw 150 length. At every point, draw 150 length. All are 150 length. Now, here you join them in cyclic order. If you join them, you again get the hexagon. There are two methods, please. One is this method, what you have drawn. What I have done? First I have drawn here. From this A, B, C, D, E, F, draw 30 degrees. Length must be all equal to 150. All lengths are 150. Now join them here like this. Right? Join them. You get both hexagons. Another method is, don't draw lines, these lines. Instead, this hexagon is there, no? Repeat here. How do you repeat? Measure this distance, mark here. Measure this distance, mark there. Like that. copy distances from here, put it here, draw hexagon. Now you got one hexagon here, another hexagon here. Join corresponding points. You got these two hexagons. See, draw similar hexagon rear side. Whatever the hexagon is here, you draw similar hexagon. Now join corresponding points. Join edges of the faces. This is second method. Whichever is convenient for you, you can do that. Now, how to draw the pyramid? This is prism. For pyramid, already I got O1. That's O1. So what I do? O1 I got. Draw a line parallel to this 30 degrees. Length is O1, O2 is 150. The center line is here. Join O2 with all other points. Join O2 with all other ABCDs. This becomes pyramid. Now for this pyramid, base is, you are able to see this. If base is on top view, this way. This is top view. On this, I draw the, this is top view. First you draw top view. Exactly height of 150. Again repeat same thing. Whatever you have done here, at the height of 150, this problem how I have solved is, I have drawn the hexagon. At every point, I did 150 length. These blue lines are not there. All lines are 150 mm. Join all of them. I get prism. Pyramid, just join O2 with all other points. So dear students, we have done planes, hexagon, pentagon, circle. Solid, one prism, one pyramid, cylinder and cone. That's all. In our syllabus, there are only four solids. Prism, pyramid, cylinder, cone. Four, then base is resting on HP, base is resting on VP. Base is resting on HP like this, base is resting on HP like this. VP, this is resting on VP, resting on HP. Total 8 problems only. Prism, pyramid, cylinder, cone, four. Resting on HP, resting on VP. Total 8 problems, not more than this. Right. Yes. Some student is asking original length or isometric length. Dear students, please listen. Question, if he says draw isometric projection, take isometric scale. If he says isometric view, don't draw isometric scale. Draw only normal scale. I cannot say. Question, you have to read the question and decide. Isometric projection means isometric scale. Otherwise, isometric. This one. Right. Now we go to dear students, this is your examination question paper, please. All of you are able to, I didn't share. This already I have sent it to you, correct? All of you got it? I think everybody has got it. Now, this is the question he has given. Dear students, this is called a I section. This is generally used in as a steel beam. In heavy constructions, bridges and all that, this is used as a beam because you can't use complete solid like this. It becomes very, very, very costly. So this, they save material by using only less material here. This is called web. 12 mm is called web. Anyway, he wants you to draw the isometric projection of this. Now, what I have done, I have taken the dimensions here. The dimensions are 50 into 60. So what I have done, I wanted to draw a box. 60 height, 75 long, 50 width. I have drawn a box, 75 long, 50 width, 90, 60. This is 75, this is 50, this is 60. First, draw a horizontal line. Mark any point. On either side, draw 30 degrees. I have drawn length here, 75, width, 50. At these 3 points, 1, 2, 3 points, draw verticals. What is the height? 60. Now, from here, join these two. At this point, draw a line parallel to this. Here you draw a line parallel to this. These two lines are drawn first. First, horizontal line, point, 30 degrees, 30 degrees. At 3 points, draw vertical 60. Now I got this. Join this and this. I got these two lines. I should get these two. Draw parallels to opposite lines. Here you draw a line parallel to this. Here you draw a line parallel to this. I got this box. Now, this is your side view, left side view. This is front view. This is top view. Top view, front view, left side view. On this side view, I draw this. Here, if you have seen this, mark here. This height, 12 mm. 12 mm I have marked here. I have drawn lines, horizontal lines. Sorry, not horizontal, parallel lines. This is 12 mm, green lines. Green lines are 12 mm from top, 12 mm from bottom. Now, take center line. This is thickness is 12. Take center line. On either side, keep 6 mm, 6 mm. If this is center line, 6 mm here, 6 mm. Total becomes 12. So this has become 12 mm. Then I have to remove line here. Erase this line. Correct? When there is a line like this, this line will be still visible. This line is visible. I have erased it. When I erase, I got this. Clear, please? Once again. On this, mark 12 mm here, mark 12 mm, join them. Here, 12 mm above, 12 mm, join them. Take center point, draw a vertical line. On either side, give 6 mm, 6 mm. I got this. Now, inside, these two lines, I erase. I got the I. Now, from these lines, draw 1, 2, 3, all these lines, you draw vertical lines. What is the length of this? 75. What are the points you have to draw? 1, 2, there is one more line, 3. 3 lines you draw. 1, 2, oh sorry, 1, 2, this 3. Also this 4th, 4th line I forgot. 1, this is, see, now each line I am going to tell you, this line belongs to this. This line belongs to this point. This one is here. And this one is this. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. There is one more line here. That is this. So, what are all the points available? Draw 75 length. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 draw. Then, these corners you will see, just join them. Wherever corners are there, join them. Now here, at this point, draw 60, make that piece. This plate you make it. Is it clear, please? 50 by 12 by 2. Oh, yes, correct. One student said, 50 divided by 12 by 2, already I have shown you 19. That's the way I calculated 19. But I wanted to tell you, this is more appropriate. First of all, there is no calculation. Suppose, dear students, you make a mistake. Then, I will not come in center. This web will go left or right. If you don't calculate properly, one student, Satvik, Satvik has calculated and shown me that's correct. But unfortunately, if you make a mistake, this web will not come in center. So whatever I explained to you is slightly better. Whichever way is comfortable, you do them. Now this is the problem. We have done it here. One second. Right. Now we go to ortho to iso. Yes. Are you getting the screen? Draw isometric view of the object shown below. Are you getting now? No? Yes. I've shared the screen. Getting now? Thank you. Yes, now you are getting, I think. Are you getting? Right, fine. Now, see, this is the figure given, please. Examination question. Now, normally we have top view below, front view above. But here he has given in the reverse way. This is only just to confuse you. He writes here top view above, front view below. Now, you have to imagine that this is below and this figure is above. Intentionally he has given this way. Now, even though it is here like this, what it means is, just I am trying to explain the figure. There is a plate. This is 30, this is 50. This is 50, this is 30. Now, in this plate, somewhere here it has been cut off 30 degrees. It has been cut off like this. That is this portion. Now, on this corner, I have one more plate like this. Small plate. Yes? Something like this. Are you able to see? A plate like this. Okay? A plate like this. And one more plate like this. One plate like this, another plate like this. That is what is shown here. This one. These are the two plates. The plates are in the shape of L. Actual plate is, this is the plate, but this triangle has been cut off. This is a plate. A triangle has been cut off here. And below, there is one more thickness plate. The plate is like this. And here it is like this. It is like this. Right. That we are going to draw now. Dimensions are already given. We will go to drawing. Now, first to draw this. I have drawn an orthographic projection, please. 30, 50, 23. I have drawn the angle. Why I have drawn? Because I told you, angle cannot be drawn in isometric. I need this dimension. 15.59, I need it. Therefore, I have drawn it. Right. Now, draw orthographic. Already you know how to draw a rectangle. Right? Now, on this, what is the thickness, please? Thickness of the plate is 10 mm. Thickness of this plate is 10 mm. And what about this another plate coming like this? What is the height? 25 minus 10. This is 15. This is 15. This is 15. The thickness is 10. 10 plus 15 is 25. 15. This is 10. Right. Now, so first I take 10 mm. Sorry. I take 10 mm on everywhere. Everywhere I take 10 mm height. Right? Now, I have taken everywhere 10 mm. Now, join all the points. Join all the points. See here, this is the figure. I have drawn, I did not draw angle 30, I marked 23 here. 16 there, join them. Everywhere I put these orange lines, height is 10 mm. Join them, all top lines. If I join, I get this figure. These lines are not visible. See, this line up to this is not visible. Anyway, these two lines are not there. These lines are not visible. Three lines, one, two, three lines are not visible. Anyway, these are not there. It's already removed. It has been cut off. Now this is bottom plate is over. On this thickness plate, I have to put 15 mm thick plates I have to put. Anyway, now I have drawn 15 mm here, 15 mm here. Draw parallel lines. Now, everywhere 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, draw heights. Everywhere you draw height. Join them in sequence. Don't join this with this. Join with sequence. And join after joining this, don't join. You go by some sequence. You started from top corner, from here to here, here to here, like that. From here to here, here to here. Join. Here. And if you remove all the inside dashed lines, this is the final figure. This is the figure. I have explained to you, I cannot draw angle 30. So I have drawn this rectangle. Parallelogram I have drawn. Mark the dimensions. Mark the dimensions 23. And this, you got this, it's not 30 degrees, 23. Is only to tell you wrong. Don't draw 30 degrees. This is wrong. So mark 23, 16. You got this. Everywhere you put the height 10 mm. Then join them. I got the plate. Rectangular plate, triangular plate removed. Now on this, from here 15 mm, here 15 mm. 15 mm, 15 mm, you draw this line. Everywhere you put 15 mm height. Join them in sequence. Everywhere 15 mm, join them in sequence. I got this. When I remove all the inside lines, I get this. This is the figure we have drawn. This is the final figure if you remove. So, in the examination, try to draw light lines. Finally, make it dark. Right. Now this is the question paper they gave it. I have drawn this again in AutoCAD. Question paper is in the examination they gave only this paper. Sometimes they do like this. Still, you have to accept. You can't question. Now anyway, I have drawn this figure for you. Right? Now there is a plate here. One plate. Small triangular plate is this. And this is a rectangular plate. On this, a semicircular hole has been cut off. This is semicircular hole. Right? So, this is what you are supposed to do. That is, see here, one piece here like this. On this, another piece. Not completely length. It is something like this. There is a gap. Gap of 10 mm. There is a gap of 10 mm. This is 50. This is 40. Here, yeah? There is a semicircular hole. And here, there is a triangular piece like this. Clear, please? Bottom plate, this is 10 mm. This is 35 minus 10. This is 35 minus 10. This is 25. This is 25. This is 10. Now, this is 40, this is 50, this gap is 10 mm. Here I have got one more triangle like this. Like this. This is what I have to draw. Right. Now, first, draw the rectangle. What is the dimensions? 50, sorry, this is 40. 40 into total length, he has not given, you have to calculate. This is 44. Where is that length? Somewhere he has, he might have given. So 80 into 40, you draw the parallelogram. Everywhere, thickness is 10 mm, completed. Now you got a plate. This bottom plate, you got it. Right? First you draw 80, 40, everywhere 10 mm. Then you join them. I get a plate. On this plate, I have to put this. So next rectangle, I'm drawing. Next, what I am drawing? Rectangular dimensions, please. What are the dimensions? This is 40 minus 10. This is 30. How much is this? This is 30. How much is this? 44. So 30 by 44. This 30 by 44 you have to draw. 44. This is 30. You mark 30 here. 44. Draw parallel lines. Everywhere draw 25 height. These are 25 height. Join them. Dashed lines you can forget. Now here we draw the circle method. Already I have shown you 4-point circle method. No, draw a rhombus, then LS center and all that. That with that procedure you have to draw the semicircle. There also you draw the semicircle. This is the semicircle you have to draw. Isometric semicircle. The method is 4-center method. What we have seen is 4-center method. You got this from here and here. Draw parallel lines to this. These lines are parallel to this. This arc is parallel to this. How do you draw? Smooth curve you draw that circle. How you draw? Best. The better you draw it, you get better marks. Now, what is left is this triangular piece. One more is this triangular piece is to be kept. Then I'm going to keep it now. From here, thickness you mark here, join them. Thickness I have marked here, draw vertical lines, you join this. Again, join this. If you remove all the inside lines are there. If you remove it, you get the final figure. You have to put minimum dimensions you have to show. You can't leave it like this. These final dimensions you must show. Right? Yes. Up to this, any problem, please? Because this will be the next last problem we are going to take up now. This has come many number of times. Shall I continue? Now, dear students, first understand this figure. This also is given in the wrong way. Normally, we are accustomed to top view is below, front view is above, side view is here. But he has given only for confusion student, but this has come many number of times in the examination. So we'll understand as it is. In case you have any problem, you draw this figure in the examination question paper only, you draw this figure below. Then all your problem will solve. If you cannot understand, you draw this figure below this. This becomes front view, this becomes top view. But I don't think it is necessary. This way you try to do this. Now, there is a rectangular piece. What is this total length? 36 plus 20, 56. From here to here it is 56. From here to here it is 32. This is a rectangular piece. What is this? 56. How much is this? 32. This is a rectangular piece. Now, in this, he has cut off like this. See, are you able to see, please? Right. See, this portion has been cut off. Here, similar portion here. That is what is this. this portion. You are able to see this? Are you able to see? Yes, I think you are able to see this. This portion has been cut off. Left side, also right side, both. Now, first is, what is the thickness of the plate? What is the thickness of this plate? I told you, one is 56, this is 32. What is the thickness of the plate? Thickness will be shown in front view. How much is this? This is thickness of plate, 8 mm. Yes, one student answered. Rohan, 518. Right, this is 8 mm thickness. So what should I do? First take, I have to draw a rectangle, 8 mm thick. First I will draw a rectangle. Rectangle looks like a parallelogram. Now I have drawn the rectangle. Now here, I will cut off that portion I will cut off. Now I am marking here. All the dimensions, whatever is given, I am marked here. Then we do, these are the lines. Say I have marked this. First I have taken center line, marked this. Wait, how do you got this 16 mm? This is 16, this is 16, 32. So this is midpoint. This is 12, 16, 12. And this is 18. You will see 12, 16, and this is 18. All the dimensions I have taken from here, I marked here. 12, 16, 18. Now, from here to here it is 12, from here to here it is 18. If I join with this, I get it. This is 12. This is, I start from here, 16, 12. From here, 18. So I join this, that's four. Now, 16, 12, this is 18. Similarly here. Now, everywhere, is there any, shall I increase this thickness here? Everywhere? No. On this place, the bottom plate is over now. There is only one more plate, this. There is only one more plate in this. The thickness is 8 mm. How much is this? I want to know how much it is. Height I will tell you. Height is 16. This piece height is 16. I want to know what is the height where he has given. Has he given or not? No, he has given. This length, he has given. Yes, somebody said 24, 1239 I said 24, that's correct. This is 14 plus 10. Yes, one more student, 511, very good. 14 plus 10, that is, this is 24. This is 24, thickness is 8, height is 16. Now, that plate, I will take it here, put it. On this, I can put it. But is this plate rectangular in shape? No. Here, after 14, it has been cut off. Triangular piece has been removed. This is the portion removed. It is not complete 24 by 16, 24 by 10. This is 16, this is 24. No, this triangular portion has been removed. I have to remove it. First, let me draw the rectangle first. I will draw rectangle. First, draw rectangle, 10 mm height, draw this piece, then again remove the portions. When I remove it, this is the portion I got. I have removed all the pieces. Right? After removing, I am taking the center point. No, I have calculated. I did not take center point here. That is 56 minus 8. Dear students, this is 56 minus 8. How much? 48 by 2. 24. That is 24. from here to here it is 24, 8, then this also becomes 24. You better calculate always. My suggestion still it is, mark the center point, mark on either side 8, 4 mm, 4 mm. That is the best method, please. But you do whichever is convenient for you. From here, mark center point, mark 4 mm on either side. All this headache is lost. Now, what is this length? 24. This is 24. Height is 16. Now, put height here. 1, 2, 3, 4 places. Height 16. I did not put here. I have already marked this center point also. That is, how much is that? 14. Sorry. This is, from here I have marked 14. This is 14. The distance already marked here, 14. So, I draw it, I join that. I join this, this becomes one point. This point I join with this, this point I join with this. This point I join with this. So, that's the point. This is an important question, please. So, so once again, this is 56, 32, 8. 56, 32, 8 thickness perpendicular I have drawn. 56, 32, 8. Now, these portions have to be removed. 16, take center point 16 from here. Here you come down 12. Here you come down 18. Join them. This is 12. This is 18. Join them. This is 12. 18, join them. And on every place, you put the height. You join this on, sorry, on these pieces, you remove the, this material, you get the shape. Now, take center point. On either side, put 4 mm, 4 mm. This is 24, 14. This you already got it. This is 24. On 14, you draw a horizontal line. On 14, you can draw a horizontal line. Then, at 1, 2, 3, 4, draw height of 15, whatever the height given. Join these four. Join these four. Then, join this point with this. Join this point with that. This will be over. Now, we go to this is, now dear students, we have covered two topics now. What are they? One is isometric projections. First, this solids you have done now. Prism, pyramid, cylinder, cone are isometric projections. Now, what all we have done now is conversion of orthographic projection, this is orthographic projection, to isometric projection. What we have done so far is conversion of orthographic to isometric. Now we go to isometric to orthographic. This is very, very important. I stop it first. Yes. Now, this will be the last topic. Dear students, as I have already told you, interpenetration, scales and conics we have left off. But all PTs are available. Please go through them. One more thing I want to tell you, for interpenetration of solids, learn only two problems. Prism, prism, cylinder, cylinder. That's all. Only two. There are many problems. Don't worry much about it. Listen, draw, prism, prism, cylinder, cylinder. But be thorough with section and development. That's more important. If you are thorough with section and development, you are sure to get 30 marks. Conversion of this is another 15, 45. Next is straight lines. Then scales and conics. It's not very difficult. Now, let's go. This is the last topic. You are getting screen now? Screen not visible. Yes, is it visible now? Right. Now, this is the next topic. Now, what we will see is, this is conversion of isometric to orthographic projections. Yes, this also is a very important question. It has come many number of times. Now, just try, we'll understand before proceeding, we understand. There's a rectangular piece. 32, 56. And there are two more plates, 16, 8. 8 thickness, 16 height, you have to tell me now. 16, this also is 8. What is the height now? Yes, anyone? Yes, this is 20 minus this 8. 20 minus 8 is 12. I got all the dimensions. 16, 8 and 12. These two pieces I have to add. And I have to make a rectangular hole. 12 by 16. Right. This is what I'm supposed to. This is the figure they gave me. Now, ortho to iso is very difficult. But this is very easy. Now he has given you arrow. Observer is here. Is seeing this. This is your front view. In the front view, you see this L. Also, you see this. This is your front view. Side view, you see this L. And you see this. Top view, from top you see this portion, entire portion with this hole, this rectangle, this rectangle. These are the things you will be seeing. Right. So, again, this is front view. Observer is looking, standing here, is seeing this, one, two. Then this is top view, this, this, and this including hole. Left side view, this one, this one. Right, we'll see now. I have marked everything here. On this question paper, with a pencil, you mark. This is front F1, F2, F3. This is front view. Side view, S1, S2. Top view, T1, T2, T3. So first, take the figure, you mark it. Now see if there is any area left out. Only the hole is left out. Hole also is in top view. Now first we'll decide. We'll draw a reference line. Yes. One student has asked me how to prepare for the AEC exam. Important questions. Already yesterday I sent a message. 11th you are going to have supplementary examination, correct? Only then I will be able to tell you something, not before that. I don't want to guess something and tell you and spoil you. If at all I tell you something, I must know it. Without knowing how, what I can do, I will not be able to tell. Now, first draw reference line XY. Now, first, again I'll go back here. This is XY, I have drawn 56, mark 56. How much is this here? 8 here. How much is here? 20. From here, 16. I started from here. See here, 56, 20, 16, come down, how much? 12, then join with 8. This is what is your front view. Again, I'm telling you, 56, 20, 16, 12, parallel line, 8. And then this rectangle, F1, F2, F3 must be covered. Let me see now. This is 56, 20, 16, 12, then parallel line. How much is this? 8. One more rectangle. Up to this height, same height. This is 16. F1, F2, F3. Are they matching, please? F1, F2, F3. Are they matching? Yes. So, we started from here. 56, 20, 16, 12, parallel line, 8. And this are same. Front view, even though you are in the isometric, you see a lot of distance, but on the same plate, you see. So that is the F3. Now front view is over. Now, don't hereafter mark dimensions. From here, draw all parallel lines. Draw construction lines, too expensive. Very light to draw. These are the, see, 1, 2, 3, 4 construction lines. Very light lines you draw. Right. After drawing, give some gap, 20 mm or so. Then you draw one dark line. This is one line. Now, this is 32. Now, we'll go back again to the again figure, that figure. I have to draw T1, T2, T3. T3 with a hole. T1, one rectangle, 16 by 8. 8 by 16. T3 rest. Inside, there's a hole. Just let me go. Now, what do I do? From here, you take the distance 16, 8, draw parallel line. 8, 16, draw a parallel line. So, T1, T2 are over. Now, here I have to draw a rectangle. That too, I have to draw it in center. I have to draw the rectangle in center. How I have drawn? How to draw it center? Now, without wasting time, I myself will tell you. He has already given you 10 mm from here. And this is 12 mm. From here, 20. Right. What you do is, from here, you mark 12 mm. Not 10 mm, sorry. This is 10 mm. This is 10 mm. This is 12. From here, you mark 20. Or from here, 10. From here, 10. From here, 20. Mark this rectangle. Now, front view is over, top view. Side view, I have to draw. But drawing side view, of course, I have drawn here. What you should do is draw a 45 degrees. From there, you take these lines. And already, I told you, how to draw side view. I think in this figure I have not shown you. Yes, now here I have shown you. All of you see here, to draw side view, this is the method. See, from here, draw 45 degrees. If it is left, you draw left. If it is right, you draw right. Now, from this, draw horizontal line up to 45 degrees. From there, you draw vertical line. See, first what we do is, here you draw 45 degrees. From here, left up to 45, then vertical. 45 degrees, left up to 45, draw vertical. This is left up to 45, draw vertical. Everything like this. This is the way. Now, here you draw all vertical lines. From here, you draw horizontal lines. Wherever they cut, locate it. Sideways is very easy, please. Draw horizontal up to 45, draw verticals. From front view, draw horizontals. Yes. Now, afterwards, I have to show these dotted lines. Otherwise, it will become a mistake. For this, these dotted lines must be shown. You project it, draw dotted lines. Here also you project it, draw dotted lines. Now, if you don't show dotted lines, it will not give the meaning of a... See, what is this? This is a plate. What is this? This also is a plate. What is this? How do you say it is a hole? This also can be plate, no? No. It is a hole. How do you say it is a hole? Because there is a dashed line here. There is a dashed line here. With this, the job is complete. Dear students, I have taken more time for explaining. It is very easy. But one thing is, you must practice. Now, second problem is this. Again, he has given you both arrows. Normally, there will be only one arrow. One arrow is front view. This is the front view. Right? Now, front view, this is one area. This is second area. This is U. U is a third area. Correct? U is one area. This is parallelogram like thing. This is rectangle. 1, 2, 3 rectangles. This portion removed. Front view is 1, 2, 3 rectangles minus this small portion. Side view, this L shape. That's all. Top view, this rectangle, and this rectangle. Now I am marked there. Now, dear students, why do you say F1, F2 and T1? If you are seeing here, just see here. You are seeing only one plane. Correct? You are seeing only one plane. Now I have turned it this way. When I turn it, are you able to see this? Yes, you can see this. And when you go top, if it is like this, they are able to see TV, correct? It may not be very clear. They are able to see TV. When I turn it this way, top view also you can see little portion you can see from top. It is here like this. Top you cannot see now. When I turn it this way, top view you are seeing. From front also you are seeing. Actually it is top view. You don't see anything in top view now. From front view you don't see top view. Only from top you can see top view. But when I turn it little, a small portion of top view you are seeing. From top also you are seeing. From front also you are seeing. That's the logic. That's why you see this portion both in front view, top view. So any area left out, please? Nothing is left out. I marked all. Only thing is this you should understand. I will show that in both front view, top view. Now, again, draw reference line. Dimensions are given. I will tell you. Generally, what I tell you, no? Sometimes, I ask students to write A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M. If you write all these things, in the front view, it becomes much easier. If you draw, after this, you draw A, B, C, D. Just I am writing only four. A, B, C, D. Just see now. A, B, C, D. Is it not easy? F1 is A, B, C, D. F1 is A, B, C, D. Now, C, D is already here. E, F. C, D, E, F. C, D, E, F. Now, G, H, I, J, K, L. G, H, I, J, K, L. This way also, it will help you. It will be faster. But I think if you do 4 or 5 problems, this writing in the business is not required. There's no need actually. Because the moment you see the figure from front view, you will understand that. Right? So this is how we do. First, again I tell you, we'll start a reference, draw a reference line. From here, start from one point, mark all the points. And afterwards, you complete F1, F2, F3, again go back to the figure. Check if you have forgotten anything you have missed here. F1, F2, F3, F4, all are there. And this figure must be a closed one. There can't be a gap. You, without this, suppose your figure is, you have got a figure without this line, then that is meaningless. You can't have any fun without this figure. You should have everything. Everything must be complete. Then again, from here, 1, 2, 3, 4, draw vertical lines. We don't say vertical lines, we say projections. Draw projections, 2H pencil. These are all 2H pencil, 1, 2, 3, 4. Very light lines. Are you able to see the difference? Very light lines you draw. Give a gap some amount, 20 mm or so, 15-20 mm. Then draw a horizontal line. Go back here. This is that line. You should get T2, T4, T3, T1. Four T's you should get. Come back. You have already drawn. Sorry. Let me take the dimensions. This is 16. How much is this? 50. 50 and 16. Now this is 50. From here you mark 16, draw a horizontal line. Already there are vertical lines from here. Now draw a first top view. What you do? Draw 4 vertical lines. Give a gap of 15 mm, draw a horizontal line. Draw vertical lines, 2H pencil, draw a horizontal line. From here 16 you mark. From here 50 you mark. This is 2H pencil only, light lines. You can erase later on. Then you darken this. T1 is this. Then T2, T4, T3. T1, T2, T3, T4. Side is only L. That will decide how you. Now, this portion I did not draw. You have to draw 45 degrees, take angle and all that. Other way also you can do. You can draw a rectangle, 48 by 50, this is 50, draw this rectangle, then mark off this, 16 mm here, or 20 mm, whatever is given, from here 16 above, join it. Now dear students, what is this height? He has given 10. This is 48. How much is this, please? How do you get that? How much is this? See, this is 48. Yes. Somebody already calculated 10. How do you get that? This is 48. 48 minus this is 20. So below is 28. 28 gone. How much is this? 10. 28 plus 10, 38. 38 gone. 48 minus 38 is 10. So that's what I've shown you here. That is what this tenement is. This tenement is. And this line you draw only after drawing this. First of all, sometimes, in this case you can draw. Sometimes if it is not possible, we draw later on. Yes, this is also one more figure. You see from your front view. 1, 2, 3 front views. Now, dear students, first I wanted to tell you one thing. See, first you mark top view. Top view is very easy because wherever 120 is there, that is top view. I forgot to tell you, this is 120. This is 120. This is 120. 120 is top view. Wherever it is. See, this is 120, 120, 120. Here also. This is 120, this is 120. This is also 120. Wherever 120 is there, you mark TV. That is, your problem is solved now. Once top view is over, two views are left. Front view and side view. Front view, whatever you see from here, you mark F. Whatever you see from here, you mark S. Finish. Top view is first you mark 120. This is 120, this is 120, like that. Now, I have marked here T1, T2. F1, F2, F3. Side one is S1, S2. Now this is 90. Height is 70. 90, 70. Front view. 90, 70. This is 35. This also is 35. Your dimension given is 30. Draw this. So F1, F2, F3. 35, 30. This is 30, 35. 30, 35. Then remaining portion is front view. 1, 2, F1, F2, F3. Those things only are drawn. F1, F2, F3. Next, draw vertical lines. 1, 2, 3, 4. Draw to each pencil. Give a gap of 20 mm. Draw this line. I should get T1, T2, T3. T1, L shape, this T2. Right? Now, this is T1, then this is T2. These are all light lines. This is dark. Now, draw a 45 degree line, horizontal up to 45 degrees, vertical. Horizontal, vertical, horizontal, vertical. From here, you draw. First, I told you, draw vertical lines, projections. Project. Top view. What is this called? Drawing horizontal lines. Project side view. I am projecting side view. I am projecting top view. Yes. This is the way. Now, draw all vertical lines, draw horizontal lines. The side view must be, this is the one. S1, S2 I have to show. S1, S2 I have shown. Now, dear students, afterwards, when sometimes doubts come, whether this line should be left side or right side. See, you draw this, but this line there will be sometimes confusion. Left side or right side. that always you see with the figure. Always this line is left side. This is L. This line is left side. Line is left side. Yes. Now, I have taken a little slightly difficult figure. Of course, this is much simpler. It looks to be difficult, but it's not difficult. So, T1, whereas the 120 is there, I put T1, T2. From this side, whatever is seen, I put F1, F2. Side 1, S1, S2, S3. Already marked here. Then, draw. 18. Height he has given 18. This is 18 plus 24. 42. This is 42, this is 18. So I have drawn a 42, 18 rectangle. All these things you measure here. All the dimensions are given. Dimensions are given. As per this, you draw vertical lines. You draw these vertical lines. Front is over. For this, you already got 4 to 5 marks you get it. 3 figures, 5 into 3. Is it difficult, please? You see? Is it difficult to draw F1, F2, F3, F4? Even in this figure, is it difficult? If there is a small mistake somewhere here, that particular marks may go. But it's not that difficult. Now, after drawing this, draw vertical lines or projections. Now, this dimension you must draw as per this. Take all the dimensions. All dimensions will be given. Sometimes, say for example, he has not given this dimension. What you are going to do? He has given this 18. How much it should be taken? I do not know. He has not given. But I have to take some dimension. How much it is better to take? Obviously, I take midpoint. 6. Somebody has said 6. I take 9. It's up to you. If it looks slightly more than this, as he says, he has chosen 6. Somebody feels it's a midpoint, take 9. Whatever it is. You can take anything. If he has not given, take your dimension. But he has given 10. Don't take 8 or 9 or anything. If he has given some dimension, take that dimension. That's all. You can't change. Because your drawing sheet is less or small or bigger, don't change dimensions. Right. Now, as per this, you project it. Right. Side view, of course, I have not drawn that 45 degrees and all that. Draw this. More than this, this also is, it looks complicated, but it is simple, please. You try these two problems in your house. You again study all the first few problems. You do just this one and this one. And one more problem I'll tell you. Okay. One more problem. Of course. These are slightly complicated. I don't expect them to come to you. If it comes, I know you should decide what to do. Right. This is one problem. It is also coming number of times. Now, dear students, there is one 16 mm plate is there, 16 mm height, 50 length. 62 length, 50 width. Length is 62, width is 50, height is 16. This is the piece. For this, a triangle has been cut here. There is one more piece, 20 width, 62 long. For that also a triangle is cut here. This is 50, 62, 16. There is one more piece, 20, 62, what is the height? this 16, this is 42. So that must be 26. The height is 26. This height is 26, 62, 20. Of course, this is a triangle is simple, last. You have to just join this piece with this over. I have to draw one plate. See, 16. So let us do this. We first mark all the F1, F2, etc. For the previous problems, if you don't mark, it is not very difficult. This you must mark. So whatever T is there, 120 degrees, mark T1, T2, T3, T4. So this is over. Top view is over. Front view, whatever you see in front view, F1, F2, F3, F4, F5. Dear students, this is F2 here. There is one more area that is hidden. When V is cut here, one figure only you are seeing. This V you see from that side. There is one more face. We'll see in the, once you draw, you'll see. Yes? Now I go here. That is the one. Draw a reference line XY, 62. Take a center line. Now, how much is this? This is 22. 22 plus 9, 31. This is center line only. This is 9. This is 22. So after 22, you have to mark one line. What is this? Has he given here? How much is this? He has not given. How much is this? Someone? Screen is not shared? I'm sorry. Sorry. Right. Okay. You are getting now? Are you getting the screen? Yes. Nice. So again, I have to repeat. Now, this is a plate. The height is 16. Length is 62, width is 50. There is a plate, 50, 62, height is 16. For this, a triangle has been cut in middle, exactly middle. Triangular portion has been cut. Here, there is a slot, rectangular slot. On this, one more plate is put. This is 42 minus 16. The height is 26. This is 26. This is 26, this is 62, this is 20. So I've got one plate, 50, 62, thickness 16. 62, 50, 16. On this, there is one more plate. One more plate, yeah. Right. We'll draw now. Before that, wherever 120 is there, I'll mark T1, T2, T3, etc. I mark it. Wherever 120 is there, T1, T2, T3 are marked. This arrow shows that is the front view. Observer is here. So I am marking F1, F2, F3, F4. Then side view S1. Even though this is visible, this is hidden under this. This triangle is S2. But from, if you see from here, S2 is hidden. You can't see S2. S1 covers it. Right. Now, I take a reference line XY. Now, center line, I mark one here line. This is 16. Then, I come here. This is 22. So, I mark 22 here. 22 here. I got this F2. What about this? This is left out. What is that? See, F2 you are seeing area. This one, if you see from here, you can understand. When I am seeing from here, I see F2. somebody opposite to me, he sees, he will see this portion. He will see this portion as like F2. I cannot see because it is covered. If I say this as F2A, if I say this is F2 dash, F2 dash, I cannot see. I cannot see F2 dash, I see F2. But a person opposite to me, he cannot see F2, he will see F2 dash. Yes. Now, on this 26 height plate, I have put it a 26 height plate. That is, this is 26 height plate, I have put it. Nice. Now, what is this? 9 mm triangle, two pieces. 9 mm here. So, put here 9 mm. From here, 9 mm. All are seen now. F1, F2A, F2, F3, F4, F5, F6, F7. All are visible. And one thing is, now height he has given 15 for this. So, how do you draw this? From center, you mark a height of 15. Draw horizontally. Already I have shown you here 15. This dimension is 15. And this is 16. So, join this point with this. Center line is a must for this. So front view got it. Now go to top view. Draw all vertical lines. These are all 2H pencil projections. Now you see, I have to mark T1, T2, T3, and this T3A also. Like this F2A, there is T3, T3A also here. That's what we are going to mark here. This is T1, T2, this is T3. This is T3A, left is T4. Of course, these two, I should have marked here. F6 I have marked here. On top view also, these are visible. Are they not visible? Slant heights, not only from front view, from top view also, they are visible. I did not put them. I should have put alphabets here. So then it would have become, I did not put it on. T4 is over. This is T5. This is T6. T5, T6 I should have put. Anyway, you take care. Again, you turn it 45 degrees. Draw this one. Yes, our time is over now. Maybe sir will disconnect. 1 second, I will talk to sir. Okay, sir is not lifting. We'll continue till he allows us. Maybe another 15 minutes. Yes. Now, this, of course, that you should not forget, draw 45 degrees, mark here, take those lines. And that S1 must be in this fashion. All dimensions are here, 50, 16, 42, 20, join this. Start from here, 50, 42, 20, slant height. That's what it looks. That's what it is looking here. This is also very, very, very simple. There is a frustrated cone, frustum of a cone, base diameter 80, top diameter 40 on that a cylinder is left. This is base diameter 80, top diameter 40, sphere is 16 diameter, height is 30. Now, side view, front view, both are same. For a cone, side view, cylinder, cone, side view, front view are same place. Top is two concentric circles. Top is 80 and 40 circles. Side view, both are same. S1, F1 are identical. Sphere also, for sphere, top view, side view, front view, all are same. Wherever you see, it is a circle only. So, sphere, how do you say it is a sphere? This SR. SR 30 is sphere radius 30. Right. Now, this will be your front view. Draw 80 here. Height is 30. First draw a center line. First draw a center line. From here, 40 on either side. Height is 30. Then 20 on either side. This trapezium you have completed. Now comes this sphere. The sphere is, you have to take center distance, isometric distance. That is 81% of 30. Center distance here must be 81% of 30. That is approximately 24. Right? So what you do is, from here, you know, oh, this is 22.36 has come. I said approximately 24. But it is 22.36. From here, you mark 22.36. With this center, 30 radius, draw a circle. Again, I tell you, draw a center line, 40 mm on either side, 30 mm height. Here, you draw 20 mm on either side. Complete the trapezium. From here, you take height, 22.36. How do you get it? 81.5% of 30 radius. Isometric radius is this. With this center, true radius 30, draw a circle. Or with this center, you take this radius and draw it. This center, this radius, you complete it. Then, top view, extend the center line. Now, first you see 60 dia. This is 60 dia, first circle. Second dia, 40. Can you see that? From top, you can't see 40. That's why this is dashed. Next you see 80 dia. How is side view? Side view is identically equal to front view. No change. You can just repeat it. Only twice it has come, this problem has come two times in the examination. This also you can see. I've shown the last examination problem, no? I section, I think I've shown you. Two more problems are there. One more sheet is there that I prefer to show you. Yes. This you take it. This is the arrow front view. 120 degrees top view. This also is top view. your front view is this. Then side view is this. This entire thing goes in side view. This we are not because we have already done so many problems. We didn't do mark it. In case you feel like that, in the examination paper also, you can please mark with your pencil. In the examination, you can mark it. Afterwards, you erase that. Similarly, I forgot to tell you one thing. When you write F1, F2, etc., it is for your understanding. Afterwards, you please erase. Don't leave like that. If any teacher gets confused, he will immediately reduce marks. F1, T1, S1 should not be seen in the answer paper afterwards. You write it for your understanding. For cross-checking, you write it. Don't leave it like that. Afterwards, you erase. No. So, first front view is L shape. This L shape, I've drawn here. Dimensions are given there. Now, project all the points. Project all 2H points. Then, I have to take these dimensions. Inverted U here. One more rectangle. This triangle is removed. Triangular portion removed here and here. Two triangular portions removed. This is also removed. Right. What I do is, this portion removed, triangular portions also removed. Dimensions are given, please. I have not taken anything, everything I have taken from here. So mark the dimensions, triangular portions is removed, this portion also is removed. And it is better, a good idea, afterwards, you make it still light. With your eraser, you can slightly erase it also. So that that should be very, very lightly visible. Construction lines should be as light as possible. Right. Now, go to side view. 45 degrees, like this. This remains same. And side view. Side view, you should get a rectangle and a hole. And this triangular portion should be cut off. You should have U cut. Right. See. Triangle, this rectangle, hole. There's a triangular portion to be cut here. This portion. Small cut is here. Here also small cut. And this is the U. This is triangular portion. This is semicircular slot. This is triangular portion. This will be very easy for us to understand again. Right? Yeah, has he given front view? He has not given. Is it better to take from left or right front view? Anyway, you can take whichever you like, you can take. Left is always better. One student already said, 5 by 10 Rohan has said, left view, it is right. Now, but I have taken right side front view, this side one. First, take 120 degrees, T1, T2. T1, T2 are 120. Now, this slant height also, you get both top view, front view. So, T3 is here. Front view from here, this is L shape, also this time. Side view, one rectangle, one triangle, one more triangle. Front view is 20, 30, 60, 10, down, this one. Same thing. Starting 20, 30, 60, 20, down up to this. Now, F2, already we have shown you. 1, 2, 3, 4 lines. 1, 2, 3, 4. Left is F2, F1 is here. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, Three names or four names? 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes, I'm getting four lines. Here I'm getting three lines. 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm getting 1, 2, 3. Now, what is the problem? Somebody answer. Three is mixed in two. Very good. Very good. Now, this line is mixed with this. They are hiding. This line is hidden under this. One student said, 3 is mixing with 2. Correct. So, 1, 2, this line also is in 2 only. 3. Very good. Now, this is 4. Are you getting same? 1, 2, 3, this line is 4. Fine. Now, next, draw horizontal lines. So, T1, T2, T3. Anything there? Are you getting T1, T2, T3? All same length, 40 only. This also is 40. Dear students, this is not 40. This is more, true length. But when you see from top, you see only 40. This length, this is not 40. It is much more. But when you see from top, it looks like 40. This is 40. T1, T2, T3. Then S1. S1 will be same thing. S1, one triangle, S2, S3. Now, if you see here, are you able to see this line? Are you able to see this line? Yes, I am able to see this line. Then, why did I put this in dashed lines? When I see, it should be dark, not dashed line. Dear students, the figure is, when I see from left side, I see dark line. Left side I see, I draw right. When I draw from right, left side, it is dashed line. When I see from here, I see dark line. When I see from left, I see dashed line. When I see from left, I see dark line. When I see from right, I get dashed line. So like that, some more problems are there. You can go through them. Right? There are many number of problems. If you go through all the problems, one more student, 1239 also, he said two lines coincided. Very good. Now, dear students, with this, except interpenetration, scales, conics. In the conics also, I sent all PPTs. Hyperbola also I have explained. So with this we conclude. There are still many number of days left out. In case you have any problem, at least there should be some minimum strength. I don't know today how many people are there. There are 52 people out of 540. 10% of the people are there, not more. So, okay, I'm not worried about the number as strength. See, it was my responsibility to conduct a drawing class, explain to you why you are drawing. That facility is not there. So, I must help you to the extent possible. I'm here ready. In case you have some doubts, similar doubts are there, we'll accumulate and meet one more day. And if it is less than only this much number, we don't have to ask sir also. We can have our own Zoom meeting, we can conduct. If the strength is less than 40 or something like that. So, don't worry much. Till 11th, you will not get any question paper. Models, I do not know. Anything if it is there. And also, if some of your ECE friends, you have any ECE friend who is writing supplementary, that question paper must be passed on to me. Then only I can pass on to all of you. You also tell all your CRs to put their message so that everybody will give you the question paper. Once it is given, it will be better for everybody. So bye. Anything? Unmute any, you can unmute now, all of you. You can unmute and tell me if you have got any problem. You can talk now. Anyone want to talk? Or shall I close? Yes? You can unmute yourself if you want to talk. Yes. I think I have already shared one paper, no? Orthographic to isometric, isometric to orthographic. Okay. I'll send it. I'll send it to CRs.